Gwynhúsle, fáltas jacadí an ciol áras náisiúnta, con lá idir náisiúnta na man a ciliúra. You're all very welcome to this special celebration of the female voice through music and spoken word here at the National Concert Hall. We began this evening with the Ukrainian national anthem, and on this International Women's Day, all the performers want to dedicate their performances tonight to the women of Ukraine. We have a vast and varied programme for you this evening, brought to you by the combined talents of the National Symphony Orchestra, and we have two Elaines at the helm, leader Elaine Clark and conductor Elaine Kelly, who is making her debut with the NSO here tonight. Elaine is the resident conductor with the Irish National Opera, and we're very lucky to have her here tonight before she jets off to Bordeaux. We're also honoured to have an incredible lineup of invited guests spanning the worlds of opera, traditional Irish music, contemporary song and poetry. So we've got a real treat in store for you tonight. Now, in a few minutes, we're going to hear a rousing fanfare from the pioneering American composer Joan Tower. But before we continue with the music, I'd like to invite to the stage a woman who's been central to the events for International Women's Day here. Chair of the National Concert Hall Board, Curtagy Faltariv, Maura McGrath.
Good evening and welcome to our beautiful National Concert Hall this evening. We join together to celebrate the arts on this very special International Women's Day. However, it's not easy to be celebratory these days as we witness the tragedy of war in Ukraine, tearing families apart as they desperately fight for their lives and freedom to safety. However, we here at the National Concert Hall will do what we do best through music, and we are already planning a concert over the coming weeks which will be dedicated to Ukraine. We stand in solidarity with all Ukrainian people this evening. However, this evening it is right to celebrate the magnificence of our artists and musicians who have graced this stage, given so much, and especially over the past 2 years. This is especially true of women artists across all art forms and all art practices. We thank you and we celebrate you. In the words of our president, Michael D. Higgins, who he, with his wife, Sabina, always support International Women's Day here at the National Concert Hall, but as you know, they're unable to join us this evening. In his words, he said, "We must ensure, as we emerge from the fog of this destructive pandemic, that our artists not only just survive, but thrive again." The National Concert Hall is rightly proud of its role as the home of music in Ireland, and we're delighted to mark the occasion this evening with our National Symphony Orchestra, whom we regard as the heartbeat of this iconic auditorium. This evening we come together in a shared experience to acknowledge and celebrate the profound effect of the arts on our lives, and especially of music, words, and song. But of course, this evening, and many other evenings, would not be possible without the generous support of our patrons, our sponsors, and the funding from our department. I'm absolutely especially delighted that this evening we have in our audience Catherine Licken, Secretary General of our department. We thank you and wish you to convey to our minister our deepest appreciation. So now, I invite you to enjoy the rapturous sounds of the men and women of the National Symphony Orchestra under the baton of Elaine Kelly. On International Women's Day, may you be well, may you be peaceful, and may you be happy. Gurmila Mila Margat.
Rousing dialogue between percussion and brass, Joan Tower's second fanfare for the Uncommon Woman, part of a series of fanfares written by Tower as a response to Copland's fanfare for the Common Man. Now we're going to move transatlantically back to these shores for a work by Elizabeth Maconchy next. Maconchy was born to Irish parents in Hertfordshire in 1907, and the family moved back here to Dublin, where teenage Elizabeth began her studies in piano and harmony and counterpoint. She continued her studies in London in the Royal College of Music under Ray Vaughan Williams. And as her style evolved, she was drawn to the more European modernism, especially that of Béla Bartók. And we're going to hear a brilliant showcase of her compositional talents now. This piece was composed in 1950, and it deftly combines the grit of European modernism and the lyrical pastoral style. Elizabeth Maconchy's Nocturne. bringing us through the journey of Dreamtime with all that tonal colour and drama. Nocturne for Orchestra, written by Elizabeth Maconchy. Now we're going to move to the poetic realm, and with a manifesto of personhood, defiance, reclamation and healing from Nigerian-Irish poet and editor and former recipient of Poetry Ireland's Access Court Bursary. She's going to read her poem, I Will Not Be Shamed. Can you please welcome Chiamaka Eni Amadi.
I will not be shamed. For the women and girls who have suffered female genital mutilation, who live in constant recovery, weighed down by despair and depression, under threat of disease and death, who face shame and stigma in their communities despite the injustice that has been done to them. In rebuilding this temple, I will not be shamed. Let me into the tabernacle. I will not be shamed. I have washed my sheets, cleaned my linens of all past sins. I will not be shamed. Let me in. I want to be the God in my own image, a deity that will not condemn me under the weight of that first sin in Eden. I will not be shamed. Let me in. To be free of resentment, I will not be shamed. To be gracefully untranscendent, I will not be shamed. To be reborn in the hot mouth of temptation, I will not be shamed. To be worthy in imperfection, I will not be shamed. To be a body in exile, I will not be shamed. To be a body in recovery, I will not be shamed. Thank you.
Thank you to Chiamaka Eni Amadi for that powerful piece and for being here to perform it for us tonight on International Women's Day. We'll be welcoming Chiamaka back onto the stage a little bit later in the show as well. More music now, and our next guest was the recipient of the RDS Bursary Award for 2020. She's a rising star in the world of opera. She's going to perform a trio of arias for us, Puccini's O Mio Babbino Caro from Gianni Schicchi, Massenet's Je Marche Sur Tous Les Chemins from Manon, and from The Marriage of Figaro, De Vieni Non Tardar. Can you please welcome soprano Ava Dodd? Transportational power of Puccini's O mio babbino caro brings us straight to those bridges in Florence and the pleas of lovesick Loretta. Beautifully performed by soprano Ava Dodd, along with works from Massenet and Mozart for her National Symphony Orchestra debut tonight. Now, to bring us to the interval and to close our first half, we have the Overture from The Wreckers by Ethel, Smyth. It's been described by critics as being the most important English opera written between the period of Purcell and Britain. And it's a fascinating subject matter. It brings us to the rugged Atlantic coast of Cornwall in the 19th century, where ships were lured to the rocks on stormy nights by the Cornish villagers and their cargoes plundered. So I'm going to hand you back to the ladies and gentlemen of the National Symphony Orchestra with conductor Elaine Kelly for The Wreckers by Ethel Smyth.
Thank you.
you're very welcome back to our second part of the evening. And we're going to bring you towards the world of tradition and folk music here in Ireland. And our next soloist to the stage is a renowned traditional musician and academic. She hails from Abbeyfeel in County Limerick. Louise Mulcahy has done incredible work in recent years to unearth the overlooked contribution and legacy of female pipers from the 1800s to 1950 here in Ireland. And that culminated in a brilliant documentary called Manon Piab. And tonight, Louise is going to be performing a piece written by the late Liam O'Flynn, and she's also going to be playing that piece on a set of Liam's B-pitched pipes. This is an emotive piece of music that was commissioned by the Irish President Mary McAleese and was also performed by Liam at her inauguration. But to tonight's performance of Andrahid's The Bridge, we are going to welcome Louise Mulcahy in an arrangement by John Tate.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to Louise Mulcahy for that incredible performance of Andrade, arranged beautifully by John Tate. Now, we have a woman who's known the length and breadth of this country for her virtuosity, her vibrancy, her salt-of-the-earth personality. I think you know who it is, do you? I was told to fill. I think she's got a few things to plug in. She's had a career spanning more than three decades. Sharon Shannon has shared her music with us here at home and around the world. And tonight, she's brought a weapon. She's going to be joined by guitarist Jim Murray, and later she'll also be teaming up with the ladies of the House 33 band. For Frenchie's Reel, we'll hear Blackbirds, which everybody knows and associates with Sharon. But first to the first of three tunes, Sharon Shannon with The Beast from the East in an arrangement by Brian Byrne. Thank you.
Thanks so much. It's such an honour to be here on this very special night. We're really, really delighted to be here with all these amazing musicians and to Elaine, of course. And So you might recognise this one. We'll go ahead with this one. Yeah. Right, make sure I have everything. Okay. Ready for action, yeah? so much, everybody. We're going to play, actually, I was so nervous about playing the guitar, and I was practicing it, and then the second tune we played there, The Blackbird, I've been playing that one for 30 years, and I made a mistake in that one. I didn't think I would have to rehearse it at all, but of course. Anyway, here goes. We're going to play a tune now, and we're going to be joined by the absolutely fantastic, amazing House 33 Bodhrán band up there in the balcony. And this one is called Frenchie's Reel.
I think the applause says it all. Nobody brings a party like Sharon Shannon. Amazing. Sharon Shannon with Jim Murray and the ladies of the House 33 Bodhrán Band. So after that flourish of notes, we're going to move to the colourful poetic imagination of Dubliner Rachael Hegarty. And I should specify, she is a proud Dublin Oneer. She is indeed the poet laureate for Dublin One. She's a graduate of the Holy Fathers in Finglas, Trinity College Dublin, and with a doctorate from Queen's University in Belfast. Rachael teaches at Trinity Access Programme because, in her own words, she says she wants more working class students causing some havoc in academia. And I really love this. Rachael's children say that she uses the three F words too much. Finglas, feminism, and feckin' poetry. So to read two of her works, the woman writer's villanelle and unmanageable revolutionaries. Can you please welcome Rachael Hegarty?
Thanks very much. You all look gorgeous. Happy Women's Day. I hope you like my new frock. It was green when I bought it in the shop, and I was backstage minding my own business when this flag reversed into it. These things happen. So I brought, this is my first International Women's Day without the Ma, so I brought her on stage with me. She carried me and I'll carry her. So I'll read this poem for all the Ma's, my Ma, all of your Ma's, and for our sisters, my sister Carolyn, my mother-in-law Angela, our sisters who are sisters not by blood but by other reasons. I tell my sons and goddaughters and nieces and nephews and great nieces and nephews that if you're going to get married, please marry a feminist. So this is the woman. Oh yeah, and just so that you know, I was lucky enough to have classes with Seamus Heaney, and I said to him once, I think I'm going to write a villanelle about what it's like to be a woman and what it's like to be a writer. And Seamus, he's very generous, he said, you're a woman and you're from Finglas, you're just going to do it in anyway. The woman writer's villanelle. Peg out your washing before you pen words. If you have the goo for chime, rhyme, recall the poetry of good drying weather for shirts. Morning fog lifts while washing cauliflower curds. Simmer a soup, add mixed spice, and stall to peg out your washing before you pen words. Hear the kids banter. Enjoy your fella's cup of flirts. Embrace the kitchen dance of the ordinary. It scrawls the poetry of good drying weather for shirts. Fit in a second wash. It might sound lula absurd, but you'll sit easier at the writing table's windy squall if you peg out your washing before you pen words. Look how the wind makes oak branches lurch. Read the sky, map the day, find a way to trawl the poetry of good drying weather for shirts. Give the children saucy sambos and meggy smiles. Then go sort out the mess of words into verse files. Fecke, find a good man, one who truly loves wild birds. Let him peg out your washing while you pen words. So the last poem I'm going to read is a commission from Dublin City Council. They asked me to write a poem to celebrate 100 years of Irish women's suffrage, which involved me going around asking anybody who looked at me sideways from under their mask, who's your favourite woman from Irish women's history? And this is what came of that. And I'll read this tonight for our sisters in Afghanistan, in Palestine, in Syria, in Yemen, and in Nigeria, and of course, in Congo. And Ukraine. Viva a free Ukraine. The boldest and most unmanageable revolutionaries. Dev called us women the boldest and most unmanageable revolutionaries. Yes. 100 years on, and we're right here to say, Dev, you weren't wrong. I learned her story as a girl. Finglas women told me of Biddy Early's healing powers. We harnessed them and carried our kin, elders and babies, through the fever hours. Rosie Hacke and Delia Larkin fought for us and ours to have safe jobs. Like St. Bridget's trick with a cloak, they took no guff from bossy yobs. Agnes O'Farrelly renewed the Breton Women's Council, rallied Cumann na mBan, armed with typewriters and guns to help Irish freedom dawn. Constant Markovitch went rifling around St. Stephen's Green. She learned Irish women's fighting ways from Grace O'Malley, our pirate queen. I learned her story as a girl. Fingless women told me the tale of that warrior Maeve. We need to stand up to bullies like Putin. Be tough, act smart, and stay brave. Dev called us women the boldest and most unmanageable of revolutionaries. Yes, see us rebels. Maná na hÉireann. Years on, women everywhere are still fighting strong. Thanks a million for having me.
Thank you very much to Rachael Hegarty for those poems of warrior women, both domestic and political. Well, we're going to invite Louise Mulcahy back to the stage now, and she's going to be joining County Louth fiddle player and composer Zoë Conway for the next section. We'll hear arrangements by Gavin Murphy for three pieces written by Zoë, which includes a world premiere of a newly commissioned piece called Ala, which means swan, and as well as an arrangement by Micheál O'Sullivan of the traditional air band of Antlana. Now, I know Zoë and Louise will have more to say about each piece, so to begin, performing Desert Storm and Rounding Malin Head, Curtagy Fáilte Roimh, Louise Mulcahy agus Zoë Conway.
It's really so special to be here tonight. I think everybody will join me in saying what a special evening this is. Certainly the company of the orchestra, Elaine, and all the team here at the National Concert Hall, of course, for making this very special night possible. So I think they really deserve a round of applause.
good evening, everybody. As I mentioned only a few minutes ago, it's a real pleasure to be here to perform in such an iconic space here in Dublin and with such an iconic orchestra and conductor, Elaine. I'm really delighted. Of course, a round of applause for everybody. It's a real treat to be here tonight, and I know we've all been looking forward to this for so long. And we celebrate tonight, of course, we celebrate being back together, but we also celebrate women today for International Women's Day. We think about the women who have gone before us and inspire us in so many different ways, and those who have yet to come, and of course, those who inspire us on a daily basis. I'm really honoured to play perform a piece for you tonight. It's called Ban Dov Aglana, or The Dark Woman of the Glen. And this, of course, comes from the beautiful playing of the master piper, Liam O'Flynn, whose anniversary occurs next week. So we remember him tonight. Of course, Liam performing so many beautiful, iconic pieces with the orchestra down through the years. So we remember him tonight, and he's such a source of inspiration for so many people in here in Ireland, and of course, across the water and around the globe. And of course, our hearts, as we say, music is a language of the soul, and our souls are with the Ukrainian people tonight. So this is for them.
Thank you. happy International Women's Day, everyone. I actually got to sit in the audience for the first half of the concert, and I was very moved to hear the Ukrainian national anthem. And I see some of the orchestra wearing their blue and yellow ribbons. My outfit's not quite so subtle. But it's more an honour dum about an seo a nocht. It's just wonderful to be here. It's wonderful to get to play again with the National Symphony Orchestra. And tonight I actually have composed a premiere, a new piece, especially for tonight and especially for Louise. And this piece is called Ala, which means swan. And I was inspired by Louise. I thought of her beautiful dresses that she wears. And I thought, you know, of all women, I suppose, that they're very elegant and there's a lot of, you know, work going on behind the scenes, that image of the swan. And Ala also means skill in Irish, so I was thinking of Louise's mastery of the uilleann pipes for that one. So, yeah, thanks. It starts with a slow waltz, a slow march rather, into two hop jigs. So these are tunes long associated with uilleann piping. And I'd like to dedicate it to my two children who are in the audience. This is for Owen and Fiona. Woo!
Thank you.
Zoë Conway and Louise Mulcahy. Thank you very much, and an amazing premiere of Allah as well to bring us towards the end of the night. And we have indeed come to the end of our International Women's Day celebrations here at the National Concert Hall. It's been a real honour to bring you this beautiful programme tonight. And to that, I want to thank the staff of the National Symphony Orchestra, to Cathy Stokes, who produced this evening's event, and also to Anthony Long, the General Manager of the NSO, for curating tonight's show. And a massive thank you to all of our guest performers who brought their unique talents and gifts to the stage tonight. And of course, to the National Symphony Orchestra, the ladies and gentlemen of the NSO, here in their new home of the National Concert Hall. I think they're settling in quite well, aren't they? Yeah. I'd like to make a special mention to the leader of the orchestra, Elaine Clark, and also to the conductor for this evening, Elaine Kelly. Well, to bring the night to a close, we have a contemporary anthem of freedom from Irish-Ghanaian singer and songwriter Ash, which is the stage name of Aisling Moore. Brian Byrne has arranged this song for Ash and the NSO, and we'll also welcome back to the stage poet Chiamaka Enyi Amadi for this finale of Freedom. Gurmagi asve an sha anocht tasulagam gur winshev sult agus tathnav asaniha agus gajeshev awalia slán.
Everybody doing? Happy International Women's Day to all the wonderful women in the world. And I just really wanted to give a special shout out to all the women in war-inflicted countries such as Yemen, Syria, Afghanistan, the Congo, and of course the Ukraine, the women that are going to fight to support their country, and also to the women that are left behind by their partners. You know, women are powerful, women are amazing. And you know what, it's great that we have a day to celebrate how amazing we are. So it's an honor to be here singing my original song, Freedom, and I want to dedicate it to all the brave women in the world. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Simplicity is my remedy.
That was terrible. Thank you so much. My name is Ash. It's been a pleasure. That's my song, Freedom. You can check it on Spotify and all that. Thank you.